Hello. Today, what we will be looking at? We will be looking at third laboratory. So, this will be laboratory 3 in the coursework, and in this lab again Alakya will be continuing teaching you the laboratory part, where today she is going to cover the inverted microscope, oven, autoclave and sonicator. Now, inverted last time what you have seen? You have seen the metallurgical microscope. This time you will be looking at the inverted microscope. We will also look at the sonicator, because sometimes when if you remember the process what I taught in the theory class, that when you use the photoresist and you want to strip of the photoresist, what you use? Use acetone, right. So, sometimes just stripping of photoresist by dipping in acetone will not work, and that is why you have to dip the wafer in the beaker which is containing acetone, and you have to load that beaker in a sonicator. So, sonicator will help to remove the or strip the photoresist with the help of acetone. We will be talking about that in the lab class. Then we require oven. So, you need to heat the substrate when you clean the wafer, right. So, how can you heat it? You can use a oven. Now, generally when we discuss in the theory class, what we discuss? We discuss that when you coat the photoresist for soft bake and for hard bake, your temperature would be 95 degrees centigrade and 120 degrees centigrade, right, and you have to use hot plate, and if you use hot plate it is for 1 minute. But if you do not have hot plate, then alternative way is to use oven. And when you use oven, the time that is from 1 minute, it will increase to around 40 to 45 minutes. So, how the oven looks like, how can we operate the oven, that will be taught to you in the in this particular lab class. And finally, she will be covering equipment called autoclave. So, what is autoclave? Anytime when you work on bacteria or cells, it is a good practice to autoclave the device or the samples before you throw in a biological waste. Autoclave is like a pressure cooker, alright. I am talking in very easy terms, but the technical details we will be looking at in the lab class. But it is similar to a pressure cooker. You are boiling water at a high temperature, and that is why the particles, or you can say the bacteria or cells, would die, right. So, the kill the bacteria or cells that are left over onto the in vitro platform, which is a microfluidic chips or any other system, right, that we use with bacteria or cells, it is a good practice to kill those bacteria or cells if they are left over before you throw in the biological waste. So, that is autoclave. We will see how the system works in the lab class. All right. So, this is what I think we will be covering in this particular lab class. You have any questions, feel free to ask, and I will see you in the theory class, right. And I will also talk about, we will also talk about a lot of other things in other lab classes. Till then, you take care, have fun with lab classes, bye.
Hello all, welcome to the next module in our course Sensors and Actuators. Today, let's see the different equipments which can be used while we are working in, or when we want to study how to fabricate devices and how to characterize them. So, here we have two sections in this laboratory. One is the characterization section with multiple workstations, and then in the other section is the biology section. Again, we have workstation and different equipments. Now, during this short video, I'm just going to brief you about the various workstations and the equipments present here, which will be detailed in our future modules as to how the devices will be used and what are the different functionality each of them offers, and when to use it, and what is the purpose behind using them. So, to begin with, we have workstation 1 here in the characterization facility. So, what we have there is the NI DAC system. Why do we need a data acquisition system? Like I said, we would be fabricating a lot of sensors for various purposes. So, it could be a flow sensor, it could be a force sensor, it could be a pressure sensor, it could be a bio-MEM, so it could be microfluidic based sensors, and for all of this there are different purposes. Like you want to measure impedance, you want to characterize them by applying certain force and all of that. So, if you have to acquire data from each of the fabricated sensors, most important part is to have the data acquisition unit. And for that, here in our workstation, the first thing what we have here is the NI-DAC system. So here, this is workstation 1, where we have the NI-DAC unit. So each of these are modules which goes into the chassis here. And this is the entire system, the virtual bench. And we will be taking you through what are the features of the virtual bench, how it can be used as a multi-source generator. So this is the virtual bench and the different DAC units which are connected to the chassis. So here this is connected to the system on this side of our workstation. So here, so this was about workbench 1 with a data acquisition unit. So now moving to the next workstation here. In this workbench, as you can see, it is quite different from the previous. What we have here is an anti-vibration table. So the workstation here is placed so that while you are studying, when you are doing your device characterization, while you use a microscope or while you use equipments like the micromanipulator, you don't want any sort of vibration to disturb your study. So this equipments are placed on a anti-vibration table. So what we have first here is the micromanipulator. So what you can do with these micromanipulators will be explained in detail in the upcoming lectures. So these are the micromanipulator arms. We have two arms here, and each of them can be controlled with micron level precision. So these are the probe stations where you can put your probes and then use them for your work. So here is the controller for the micromanipulator. Each of this will be detailed and their application will be discussed in the next modules. Another unit what goes on the anti-vibration table is with the micromanipulator, what we have here is the LCR meter. We will learn about how to set the frequency range, how do you do the calibration, and how do you take the readings, accurate readings at precise levels using the LCR Q meter again in our future module. Next, equipment on the anti-vibration table, the workstation 2 here, are the microscope. So here we have a stereo microscope and then we have the metallurgical microscope. So again, the choice of microscope for your study becomes important when you're talking about silicon chip or MEMS based devices which you have fabricated with silicon as substrate. This is the choice of microscope. The metallurgical microscope becomes important, and how the objective is placed and how you can take images or even take videos using this microscope and the different types of lens which can be used and the different magnification levels, all of that will be discussed in our upcoming lectures. So this was about the workstation 2. So now that we've seen the characterization facility, let's move into the biology section, which is on the other side. Like I mentioned, these were the HEPA filters which are facing towards the characterization facility. And now as I enter the biology section, so this is the biology section. Here again, like I mentioned, we have the HEPA filter towers. There's one tower here, and exactly we have another tower on this side, as you can see the tower here. So these two towers are facing in such a manner that the biology section has the air filtered in a proper manner. So where I'm standing here is the biology section here in our facility. And the first equipment what we have here is the incubator. So we have two types of incubators. So this is the shaker incubator and then this is the static incubator. You have to control while you are talking about cell and tissue culture. You might have to maintain the CO2 levels, temperature and humidity depending on the sample for appropriate growth of these samples. So hence you have a shaker incubator where the samples are being vibrated at a certain rate. So you can set the RPM in this equipment here. Again, why do you have to vibrate while you are doing cell culture? All of that will be discussed in the future modules. So this is the incubator here. Moving forward, here we have the peristaltic pump and a sequence of desiccators of varying sizes. So why do we have these desiccators or equipments here is every time you fabricate, like you can see there are devices inside each of these. So there's vacuum which is maintained inside the desiccators. So these are contained equipments where you can put your devices just so that they are left for storage in vacuum and the outside and air does not contaminate these devices. Like it is always interesting to know when you're talking about silicon or MEMS based devices, silicon substrate is always attracted towards it is hydrophobic, like it always attracts water or moisture. And what happens is the water, once it gets settled onto on the surface of silicon, then it is contaminated. And device fabrication would really not fetch you with good results. And hence, to prevent all of such contamination due to external environment, you always store your devices into the desiccators like this, use a pump and then maintain vacuum inside this and leave it until you come back to the station and you carry them to another place, maybe another facility, then you can easily carry this using the desiccators here. So next here we have the hot plate with a temperature, closed loop temperature control system, a magnetic vibrator as well. And why do we use the hot plate? Again, an important step during the microfabrication process, soft baking. Every time you spin coat, you will have to bake, and that is when you use the hot plate in order to remove the dissolved solvents in the photoresist that you spin coated. So for that purpose we have a hot plate here, and then comes the microscope. What we have here is the inverted microscope. Again, the previous two microscope, the stereo and the metallurgical microscope, were used in the characterization facility. Here the inverted microscope becomes important because cells and tissue samples, the tendency of these is live, cells, they have a tendency to remain at the bottom of the petri dish or the cell culture. So it becomes important for you to have your lens at the bottom so that you can view them from the bottom of your the petri dish. And with that motive, we have the inverted microscope here in the biology section. Moving forward, after the microscope here, we have a microwave oven. So when we are making microfluidic devices, you have PDMS polymer which is being used for molding, and for that you will have to bake them at 70 degrees Celsius for around 2 hours, and for all that purpose we are using a microwave oven. And then on this part, on this section of the biology section here, we have various acetone, IPA, ethanol, all of these are kept here so that when you want to clean your device even before fabricating, you use acetone and IPA. So all of that have been contained into the rack here. And then we have a sonicator in case you want to have this. Again, details about what is a sonicator and how does it become an important part of fabrication facility, all of that will be discussed. So this here is a micromanipulator, the sonicator. And next we have an autoclave on one end autoclave is again basically used to every time you need to autoclave or cleanse, sanitize your devices, then that's when you use these autoclaves. Each of them will be briefed to you in detail and the containers there for discarding the biohazard or in case you want to discard the gloves or the devices, we would discard them in a specified container. So once that we've seen how the autoclave is used, the last most important equipment in the biology section is the biosafety hood. And this is a level 2 BSL hood, and again there are different levels and classification, all of that again will be discussed. So here it becomes important how you use the biosafety hood while you are working, so that your the sash does not go beyond, you know, your hands, or when you are working you make sure you just sit here and then you have the sash open and then just your hands remain exposed, and then at this level you work so that there is no aerosol or other sort of contamination which could affect you. So this is the biosafety hood, and the details about the safety hood again will be explained in future. So this was all about how the biology section and the characterization facility are equipped with different equipments. Let's see how to use them, and going forward we'll see how to fabricate devices and how the facility can be used. Thank you.